Welcome back to the 2 Minute Warning. Today I'm taking a look at the Tennessee Titans, going over whether or not I think they have the best offense in the NFL, of course, for the upcoming season in the NFL in 2021. But before getting to that topic, just a quick note for those of you viewing, I want to hear from you guys. Where do you rank Ryan Tannehill amongst quarterbacks in the NFL? You got him being in the top 10, right outside the top 10. You got him being top 5, whatever it is, comment down below where you have Ryan Tannehill and you kind of hear my thoughts around. And while you guys are at it, comment down a video idea you want to see me do, and I'll look into it and see if I can get it done. If you don't mind as well, drop a like below. It really helps me out. But getting straight into it, looking at the Tennessee Titans, obviously the elephant in the room that's really going to put this team in the talks of being the best offense in the NFL is Julio Jones. A lot is going to be dependent on that. Can Julio Jones recover from his injury perfectly? Can he be fine going on 33 years old? Can Ryan Tannehill, you know, as good as Ryan Tannehill is, does he have the arm to produce and, you know, create the output that would satisfy both A.J. Brown and both Julio Jones? I don't know. These are the questions we're going to have to answer. A couple things that are holding me back from putting them at number one, you know, holding the crown. And just because I don't have them at number one doesn't mean I don't have the Titans at two or three. And I'm not necessarily saying I don't have them at number one right now. I got to talk through it. But a couple things that would hold me back is, A, Ryan Tannehill being a top 10-ish quarterback is going to hold me back because he's not on that same level as Aaron Rodgers, Patrick Mahomes, Russell Wilson, Deshaun Watson. You know, I'm not saying Deshaun Watson, the Texans, they got the best offense. You guys know what I mean. Tannehill doesn't have that it factor of being the tier one guy. So that's one little thing that holds me back. Another one, their offensive line. It's a stout offensive line, but there are some better ones in the NFL. You know, it's not tier one, you know, and I know Titans fans are going to be like, what do you mean we're not top five? Well, why don't you be a little more biased, please? Titans, you don't have a top five offensive line. Is it good? Yes. But I mean, Pro Football Focus, they got them at number 14. I'm going to trust Pro Football Focus, the website, the scouting report, the analyst, whatever you want to use. That includes every variable there is when grading players and teams, not the biased Titans fan. And again, I'm not trying to be rude or disrespectful. I'm just saying they're not top five. They're ranked right around 14. I do think they're better than 14. I think they cracked the top 10. That's another thing that holds me back. As good as top 10 quarterback is, as good as top 10 online is, we're talking about number one offense in the NFL, and that's why I got to hold them back a little bit. But there's some pros of this Titans team. Derrick Henry, A, best running back in the league. That's going to, you know, bump you up the list, of course. Receiving core, Julio Jones is arguably a top five receiver in the league. Some people have him as the third best receiver in the league. A.J. Brown, he's right on the brink of being a top 10. Some people have him top 10 in the league. If you ask the right guy, you might hear that Julio Jones is the third best wide receiver in the league and A.J. Brown's the 10th best. You know, right there, that's a pretty good duo that could put you at the number one offensive league. I do personally agree that the Titans have the best wide receiver duo in the league. I'm a Bucs fan. Mike Evans, Chris Godwin, Mike Evans, Antonio Brown. I like that duo, but I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to be crazy. The Titans have a better wide receiver duo than the Bucs. You know, the Chiefs got a good one. Tyreek Hill, Travis Kelce, Bills, Stephon Diggs, Cole Beasley. There's plenty out there. DeAndre Hopkins, AJ Green's going to be a good one. Keenan Allen, Mike Williams, DJ Moore, Robbie Anderson. You guys know the drill. There's a bunch out there. Amari Cooper, CeeDee Lamb. But Titans got the number one wide receiver duo in the NFL. Got some depth behind it. Anthony Firkser. He's not Jonnu Smith, but he's still a viable tight end that's not being required to be this athletic red zone guy that Jonnu Smith was kind of sought out to be. Because you got Julio Jones and A.J. Brown to get the job done. You just need Anthony Firkser to be reliable. Josh Reynolds, is he star-studded? No. Is he a good wide receiver three, though? Yes, 100%. Mike Vrabel, well-rounded coach. A couple things that worry me, though, is the loss of Jonnu Smith, is the loss of the offensive coordinator Arthur Smith, is the offensive line, and is Ryan Tannehill again? Again, I'm not saying Mike Vrabel bad. I'm not saying the offensive line is bad. I'm not saying Ryan Tannehill is bad. I'm just saying when we're grading and judging whether or not the Titans have the number one offense in the league, I feel like I can't give it to them when they don't have those tier one factors. Can Derrick Henry get them there in the conversation? Can Julio Jones and AJ Brown's tandem get them there and put them in the conversation? Of course, 100%. But I just think Ryan Tannehill and the offensive line will slightly hold them back. They might be top two. They might be top three. I think they're probably going to be a top five offense in the league, arguably. But I can't give them number one yet. Maybe once I actually see them play, yeah. But I have to see on paper. It's just really hard to give the crown to the team that hasn't all played together yet. I can't. It's just way too soon. I like Julio Jones. He's arguably my favorite player in the NFL. So I'm rooting for him in that sake to really recover and bounce back and take this Titans team far. But just not seeing him play in Tennessee yet, not being in this offense yet, not being back from this injury yet, not being 33 and playing in the NFL yet, it's just too early to give the crown to them. I like the Bucks as possibly the number one offense. You got the GOAT. Backfield is as good as Derrick Henry and them? Of course not. It's not even really comparable. Offensive line, though, is it the same as or better? Yes. Is the receiving core the duo? Of course, Mike Evans and Chris Godwin's not as good as A.J. Brown and Julio Jones. But after that, when you get into the depth charts and the deeper spots in the receiving rooms, I like Scotty Miller. I like Antonio Brown. I like Tyron Johnson. I like Rob Gronkowski. I like athletic O.J. Howard. I like reliable Cameron Brate. Better than, you know, third, fourth, and fifth strings that the Titans got. Like I said, I like Josh Reynolds and Anthony Firkser, but I'm going to take Antonio Brown and Rob Gronkowski over them two. And therefore, as a wide receiver room as a whole, I got to give it to the Bucks. And, you know, call me biased Bucks fans. I'm not. I'm trying to be as biased as I can. Chiefs, they have a great offense as well. Patrick Mahomes, you got the best quarterback in the league. Say what you want about the O-line's awful. You got Orlando Brown Jr. You got Joe Tooney. You have Kyle Long at retirement. You drafted Austin Blythe. Who was it they picked up? The best center in the draft. I believe his name was Creed Humphrey. They got Mike Remmers at right tackle. They have a rebuilt offensive line. Like I said, Tyreek Hill and Travis Kelce. You could argue them to be the best wide receiver duo in the NFL, better than A.J. Brown and Julio. Do I think they are? No. I'm just saying they're right up there in talent. Backfield's pretty well-rounded and Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Are they Derrick Henry? No. But I'm just saying these other teams out there that, you know, have better pros and have more cons than the Titans, and that's why the debate is there. Browns, they're very well-rounded. Best offensive line, best backfield duo in the NFL. Nick Chubb, Kareem Hunt. Wide receiver room, you could argue it's better than the Titans. Is it star-studded? Does it have as much star power at the top of the Titans? No, but is it just like the Bucks? It has more depth. After OBJ and Jarvis Landry in the top two guys, there's Peoples Jones, there's Rashard Higgins, there's David Njoku, there's Austin Hooper, Baker Mayfield. You could argue he's better than Ryan Tannehill. I don't know if I'd put him that far, but just saying, there's other teams out there that have been together, they've won Super Bowls together, they've gone to Super Bowls together, Bucks, Chiefs. I can't give the crown to the Titans just yet. Again, Titans fans, I know you're going to harp on me saying, oh my God, how do you not have the number one? I respect the Titans. I think they're going to possibly be a top five offense yet, but to officially give the number one, it's just way too soon, not seeing these guys all play together. I haven't seen how they're going to be after losing Arthur Smith. I haven't seen Julio Jones after his injury. I haven't seen him in this new offense. And I don't know if that's really going to just instantly make up for losing Arthur Smith, a Pro Bowl wide receiver. Do I think it can? Of course. Can I think it replace him and do more and then some? Yes, but I'm just saying I have to see it actually happen before titling the Titans number one offense in the NFL. I like what they got this year. I think they absolutely won the Julio Jones trade, and that was one of the best steals in this offseason, one of the best moves in this offseason. Credit to the Titans 100%, but I'm not giving them the crown as the number one offense in the NFL. I just can't yet. I got to give it to probably the Bucks or the Chiefs. Ravens are very electric. Lamar Jackson, you could argue the Ravens' run game is one of the few teams that can match the Titans' run game between Lamar Jackson, J.K. Dobbins, and Gus Edwards. Through the air, I'd probably give the edge to Tannehill and A.J. Brown and Julio Jones, but we got to see how Sammy Watkins, Marquise Brown, Rashad Bateman, Mark Andrews does in this new passing game of the Ravens. It might be just as electric. Bills, we know how good Josh Allen is through the air. Aaron Rodgers, Devontae Adams, Matt Stafford with the Rams. There's a lot of fantastic offenses out there, and while the Titans are on par with every single one of them, I don't think they're better than every single one of them. But as always, guys, I do want to hear your opinion. As always, I truly appreciate you watching. Referring back to the question of the day, where do you rank Tannehill as a quarterback in the NFL? To me, he's right around top 10. He's either 9, 10, or 11. I'd have to really look at it. But I think he's on the brink of top 10, and I think he will break top 10 this year if he isn't already. Again, he's right around that range for me. I haven't really ranked my QBs just yet. But as always, and of course, like I said, thank you for watching. 2-Minute Warning.